Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 2058, running total at the end of each page. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question sent in by Wiley. Wiley wants to show a running total of revenue and percentage of category in the last row of each printed page. And so Wiley has printed reports here with tons and tons of records, multiple pages for each category over there in column A. And when we get down to the end of the printed page, Wiley is looking for a total here that shows total revenue, running total inside this category, and then percentage of the category. And so you can see we're at 9.7% there. When I go to page 2, 21.1, page 3, 33.3, and so on. And at the page break, where we get done with category A, grand total for the category and the grand total 100%. All right, and when Wiley asked me about this, it's like, oh no, yeah, I mean, there's no way in the footer to put a running total. All right, so this is admittedly a horrible, cheap cheat. And I encourage anyone who's watching this on YouTube, if you have a better way, please, by all means, mention that in the comments. All right, and so my idea is just out there in columns G and H to hide the running total and the percentage of category in every single row, right? And then we'll use a macro to detect if we're at the end of the page. All right, so the two formulas that we want here say, hey, if this category is equal to the previous category, so if A6 is equal to A5, then take the sum of this revenue, so that's in F6, and the previous running total up there in G5. Now, because I'm using the sum function here, this does not error out if we would ever try and add running total. Otherwise, we're just going to be at a brand new category. So when we switch from A to B, we'll just take the sum of the value to the left of us, which I could have just put F6 there. But here we are, too late. And then percentage of category, this one's going to be horribly inefficient. We take the revenue on this row divided by the sum of all of the revenue where the category is equal to A6. So these are all the categories. This is the category in this row, and then add up the corresponding cell from all rows. Of course, dollar signs, 1, 2, 3, 4 dollar signs there, no dollar signs in A6, and 4 dollar signs there. All right, and we'll show this number as a number, maybe a thousand separator, click OK, and then here as a percentage with one decimal place, like that. All right, and we'll copy this formula down to all cells. Bam, like that. All right, but now the goal here is to make sure that we only see those totals when we get to the page break. All right, so right there, that's an automatic page break, and then later on when we switch from the end of A to B, a manual page break. So this manual page break here is different than an automatic page break. All right, now you'll notice up here that this file is saved as an XLSX file, because that's how Excel wants to save files. XLSX is the broken file type that does not allow macros, right? Worst file type in the world. So do not skip this step, or this all of your work from here on out will be lost. Save as, and we're going to save not as an Excel workbook, but as a macro-enabled workbook, or as a binary workbook, or as an XLS. I'm going to go with macro-enabled workbook. If you don't do that step, you are about to lose the rest of the work that you do. All right, and then if you've never run macros before, we're going to right click and say customize the ribbon. Over here on the right hand side, choose the box for developer. That'll get you a developer tab. Once you have the developer tab, we can go to macro security. By default, it's going to be up here, disable all macros, and don't tell me that you've disabled all macros. You want to switch down to the second one. That way, when we open the file, it'll say, hey, there's macros here. Did you create these? Are you okay with this? And you can say, enable the macros. All right, click OK. Now we're going to switch over to the Visual Basic Editor. If you've never used Visual Basic before, you're going to start out with this completely gray screen. Go to View and the Project Explorer. Here's a list of all the open workbooks. So I have the Solver add-in open, I have my personal macro workbook, and here's the workbook that I'm working on. Make sure that this workbook is selected. Do Insert Module. Insert Module, get a nice big blank white canvas here. All right, and then you're going to type this code. All right, now we're using an object here called a H page break, a horizontal page break. And because I don't use these a lot, I had to declare it up here as a variable, as an object, HPB. That way, I would be able to see the choices that are available to me in each one. All right, figure out where the last row with data is today. So I'm using column A. I'm going to the end of column A, A1048576. This is an L here, not a 1. This is an L. Everyone screws that up. L is an Excel. It sounds like Excel. Get it? Excel up. So go to A1048576, press the end key and the up arrow key to get to the last row. Figure out what row that is. And then in columns G and H, and if you're watching this, you need to take a look at your Excel data and figure out where your two new columns are, right? I don't know how many columns you have. Maybe your new columns are over in I and J, or maybe they're in C and D. I don't know. Figure out where those are, and we're going to hide all of those rows, all right? So in my case, it was starting from G6, that's the first place where we have a number, colon H, and then I'm concatenating the last row that we have today. Using a number format of 3 semicolons, that will hide the data. All right, then this next one, I learned this next one from the Mr. Excel message board. If you don't put the active window in page break preview mode before you run this code will not work. It works for some of the page breaks, but not all of the page breaks, so you have to temporarily display the page breaks. And then a loop here for each, this is my object variable HPB and ActiveSheet.h page breaks, figure out the last row, right? So for this object, for the page break, figure out the location, figure out the row, and this is actually the first row of the next page, so I have to subtract 1 from that, all right? And then here, I admit this is incredibly cheap. Go out to column 7, which is column G, change the number format to be currency, just of that row, and then go out to column 8, which is H, and change it to a percentage, and then go next. Finally, exit horizontal or page break preview and go back into normal view. All right, so that's our code. I will file, close, and return to Microsoft Excel. I want an easy way to run this, so I'm going to insert, choose a nice shape here. I always choose a rounded rectangle. Draw my rounded rectangle in. Page layout, go to effects, choose the effects for Office 2007. And then here on the Format tab, we have a nice way to add some glow to that. All right, so we've created a button. I'm just going to say Reset Page Breaks Totals. We're going to center that. So on the Home tab, center vertically, center horizontally, increase the height, and then right-click, Assign Macro, and say that we're adding it to Find All Page Breaks 2, click OK. All right, and then you see we have all of our totals here, and I reset Page Break Totals, and now it's the totals are still there, the formula is still there, but it's hidden them, except for on the rows that is the last page break. All right, now I just want you to notice here that we're in A46 and A93. Page breaks are funny things. If you change the margins around a little bit, if you change the header footer, then the page break is going to move to a new spot. So we'll go to wide margins, and the page break moved, and those numbers in the wrong spot. Also, print titles. I want rows 1 to 4 to appear at the top of each page, which means that we're going to have less rows. And so then, again, you know, now my totals are in completely the wrong place. That's why I need that button back here to reset page break totals. And you will see that now it's this cell in row 45 and this cell in row 86 that's in a new place. All right, so today's question from Wiley. We want to print category running total and percentage of category at the bottom of each printed page. There's nothing in the Excel user interface that can let a formula know that you're at the bottom of the printed page. Yeah, you can see the page breaks, but the formulas can't see them. So one possible solution, and I'm welcoming others in the YouTube comments, use a macro. So add the running total and percentage of category for each row, hide all those rows. Here's the two formulas that we used. Save as to save the workbook as XLSM, or your macros will not be allowed to run next time. They'll actually, you'll lose your macros. If you've never used macros, change the macro security, show the developer tab, switch to VBA, insert a module, type the code, and then assign that macro to a shape. As the page size changes, reset the macro, and you will have a cheap solution to what Wiley is trying to do. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.